Hello and welcome to the third chapter in our QF test Java tutorial. And in this part, we will have a look how to create procedures in QF test. Procedures are a very helpful feature to make sequences reusable. And that means that identical parts just need to be created and maintained once, but can be used on multiple positions. So I will show you how to identify reusable parts, how to create procedures in a manual way, and also how procedures can be created by transforming nodes. So I again will use the first Java test suite that I have used in the first two chapters, and it contains two test cases, and both test cases have identical parts, and one identical part is the reset test step, which uses three mouse clicks to bring our demo application into a dedicated state at the beginning. And in order to create a procedure, I use the procedures node here, which is available in every test suite. It is meant to create and maintain procedures inside this node. And I use the menu insert, procedure nodes, procedure. And now I can define a name for my procedure. I will simply call it reset. Press OK and have it ready. Now I can use my three mouse clicks and move them down into my procedure to have the relevant content for my procedure. Then I also want to use it at the initial position, and for that I select the reset node, again use insert, procedure nodes, and now there is a procedure call here. And I could either directly specify the reset procedure here, or I use this select button, which shows me what kind of procedures are available here in my test suite first Java tests. And I can directly select the reset procedure, say OK. Now reset is inserted here. I press once again OK and have a procedure call inserted as intended. Now I also want to use this procedure call in the second reset sequence. For this, I delete the three mouse clicks and use copy paste, copy, Control C, and Control V, paste to have the procedure call duplicated. Now I have the same behavior as before creating the procedure. And to verify this, I can simply start my demo and can select the reset node, and when playing it you can see it works. And if you have a closer look here at the execution indicators, these small error indicators, you can see that the execution jumps from the reset call procedure call into the procedure. I do it once again. Okay, and you can see it works. So now the second way to create procedures, an alternate way, which often is faster than doing it by hand. For this, I go back to my initial suite and reload it to have the initial state. And now I select the test step that I want to make a procedure for, press right mouse button, and can use transform nodes into procedure. And now we can see directly a procedure call is created, and automatically the content of the test step node has been moved down here into the procedures, and it is transformed into a procedure node called reset as before. So if I want to have reset to be renamed, for instance, to have it without a capital R, I can do it here, simply rename it, make OK. So I also want to use this procedure call in my second test case. So I again can remove the mouse clicks and put a procedure call in here. And you can see I can also use drag and drop to drag a procedure into my test cases. Automatically a procedure call will be created. Here in the second test case, I still have my test step node. Here in the first, the test step node has been transformed, so it's not here anymore. If I want to have it once again, I can simply use copy and paste here again my test step node and can remove that one. And then now I have the same situation as I had before when using the traditional way for creating procedures. Just one more hint here. If I want to rename my procedure, for instance, I want to have not a capital R, but a lowercase r, and do that, I will be automatically asked whether I want to update all the references or the procedure calls that use this procedure. Want to do that typically, and so I say yes, then I will get here an overview what procedure calls have been changed here in my first and my second test case. And you can see both positions have been updated. Okay, this was the third chapter about procedures, but we will come back later on again to procedures, and I will explain how to use parameters and how to create more complex procedures, but this will be in one of the next chapters. Yeah, so far, have fun. Bye.